Greetings, friends and enemies. It's been a minute. Let's see. The Love is Dead stream was like a solid month ago. But as always, I'm Suspicious V, and I'm coming to you from my new office. It's been, really great for the whole mental health type situation that, you know, I've got going on. And, if I remember correctly, we're about to sneak in here and do some things. Let's, check the quest log just so we know what we're doing. Hey, show me the orbs. Welcome back. Yeah, free the NCR troopers being held hostage by the Great Khans. We're just gonna get right into it. You'll have to excuse me if there's a bit of echo. This is a very new room. There's not a whole lot, there's not much on the walls right now. I've kind of just got my flag over there. So it's gonna be a bit before I can get stuff for all of the walls to kill the echo. But I will be doing that whenever I am able to. Affected. Using CR troopers? Oh, okay. Well, I guess I'm not sneaking in. I know I've got a bigger gun around here somewhere. Oh, you can't hear any echo. Well, that's good. Oh, you want the big iron? I can happily provide with big iron. You didn't see that, Boone.
Man, I thought I was dead for sure.
Well, you're welcome. Because now you're not dead. Okay, gotta find all the troopers.
Take him out.
Ah, shit.
Had enough?
Night, night. Ooh. He's got 12 gauge rounds. Chairman job offer. How am I doing on shotgun based situations? Hey, I've got a cavalry shotgun. Oh, it's on 5. Okay. Oh, we leveled up. Hell yeah. Science. What do you have? Bottle caps, some fixer. You figure out what all of these are. Where's my rifle? That's my shotgun. That's my plasma pistol. That's my big iron. 3 is my ripper. 7, 8, and 9 are currently unassigned. Murphy! Ooh, purified water. That's useful. So stealing from these guys I just killed is bad karma. Okay. Because that makes sense. I just don't feel like it's really worth taking. I know I can break it down into materials or whatever, but... eh. I like to carry a lot of equipment, so I tend to keep my, I tend to try to keep my carrying weight down a bit. I can take this gun, though. That's worth taking to sell. So, I guess I haven't mentioned in quite a while, this is my first time playing New Vegas. I've literally never played it before. So the way that I go about things might be a little weird. Critical chance plus 5. Okay. Cool. That might be useful at some point. And, like, I'm sure it is worth a few caps, but, like, it's also everywhere, so.
Patrolling the Mojave almost makes you wish for a nuclear winter.
Where the hell is this trying to send me? Confront Benny at the Topps Casino. Okay. Yeah, I didn't have the science to do that. That's right. I need to get my science up to, I think, 50 for that. So it wants me to start heading towards New Vegas. It isn't too terribly far from here, actually. Just follow the main road. See, I never even made it that far. I honestly don't think I ever played more than, like, just the very, very beginning. And it wasn't, like, due to lack of interest or anything. I just would start playing, play through the very beginning of the game, and then lose all interest in continuing. Got a traveling trader here.
Hey there. Need anything?
Show me what you got.
Here's what I've got.
Gauge pulse slugs. Interesting. Lots of creepy ass sounds going on out here. We should probably discover this location. There's a robot over there. Repcon headquarters.
How may I serve you, mistress?
All right. Oh, well, yeah, that might actually be worth taking. Since it has a weight of 0, did not mean to take that book. Hope you're ready, Boone. We might have a fight on our hands here. Yep. Oh damn, Boone. Oh, that was me. What? Okay. I mean, I didn't fire intentionally, but I'll take it.
Keep looking. I've got nothing.
I'll use bats in certain situations. I don't, like, rely on it, though.
I pity anyone who crosses Boyd. That woman is relentless.
That's fair. It is very useful. But I think it's, bats is very much based on what your perception skill is, and I'm not really building perception. That's valid. That's, you know, why that option's there. I mostly just use bats if I'm in, like, a really sticky situation. Oh. Optimization. Oh, there it goes. But like, even in Fallout 3 and 4, I don't use bats much. It might partly be that I've played like a lot of first-person shooters over the years. So I feel like, well, I'm fairly decent at the whole aiming thing. So now that I say that, you can go back and, Companion Dismissal Terminal. Well, I don't really want to dismiss Boone.
Welcome, sir or madam. Do you wish to purchase something?
Maybe.
All Gunrunner merchandise is constructed on site. This kiosk was specially constructed around me to deter theft and assault. I am ready to process our transaction.
Okay, Vendotron. Damn, he's got a hell of a lot of ammo. Yeah, ooh, almost 8,000 caps. Though I guess that is an anti-material rifle, which is a pretty damn big gun.
Come back.
Basically need primers for all of that. Oh, here we go. The door. This is what I was looking for. Ralph. Oh, Mick and Ralph, so.
Good day.
You're named, so you must be at least somewhat important.
Looking for a fix, man? I got what you need. Have a look.
Dixon's Jet. Dixon's Whiskey. Okay, so you're a drug dealer.
Yep.
got you in this sentence.
You like that? Had enough?
Oh, you want a melee fight? I'll give you a fucking melee fight. How the fuck you like that? I can come at me with that bullshit. Yeah, they chose incorrectly, for sure. What the hell are you running off to?
Check it out, between the dumpsters there. Nah, just some idiot that wandered down the wrong alley. Sound familiar?
No, the fuck you ain't.
All right, it's over.
You know, I'm not sure. It may have been a perk that I took, at some point. It might be from a mod. I am really not sure why it's doing that.
What do you need? Bye.
Oh, you don't want any now, huh? That's what I fucking thought. Hey Ben, welcome to the stream, buddy.
Come to Mick and Ralph's for all your shopping needs. You're funny looking. Come to Mick and Ralph's for all your shopping
needs. You wanna fucking repeat that? Yeah, that's not a fucking thought.
The followers are here. I'd probably be dead now if it weren't for the doctors.
All right, this is the gang of Elvis impersonators.
You look new to Freeside, so here's a little advice, friend. Don't go past the Southgate greeter without talking to it first. Those bots are programmed to vaporize anyone who enters the fenced-in area without authorization from the greeter. The name's Old Ben. I've been living in Freeside since the day I was born.
Is that right?
I've done a bit of everything around here. Courier, butcher, crier, escort, gun for hire. Some of which I'm not proud of, but I do my best to help around town when needed. Exactly one of the reasons I got out of that job. Too many shifty characters looking to have someone else move their hot items. My father ran a butcher shop here in town, but business went downhill when another vendor started selling this strange meat at half our prices.
That sounds odd.
You're telling me, not long after my father's shop went under and he passed away from the loss, people around town started experiencing shakes. No one gets shakes like that unless they're eating human flesh. But no one would believe me. This sick bastard gradually went insane and passed away. Wasn't long before someone moved into the guy's place and found half-buried human remains in the crawl space. I didn't bother saying, "Told you so."
Hmm.
After a while, I made enough money to get a passport into Vegas. Back then, you could get approved for entry for a fraction of what it costs now. Well, I got a job working as a crier outside of the Tops, advertising for the local talent performing at the casino. That didn't last long. Well, being a suave young guy, I chatted up the ladies from time to time, and one of the manager's girls started to take a liking to me. I never touched a woman, but the jealous prick decided it was my time to go. He framed
Fuck me, off,
saying
it was
stolen from the casino. Sure enough, a few grand was missing from the casino vault. I have to assume the bastard stole the funds and figured I was a convenient fall guy. Yeah, shit indeed happens.
It sure fucking does.
I stripped my casino apartment and all of my belongings and booted back into Freeside. From there, I didn't have a lot of career options, as my rep was destroyed. So the escort job sort of fell into my lap. No pun intended.
Yeah, okay, that would be right up Jam Graham's alley.
Well, I suppose you could look at it that way, but I was packing a whole different kind of heat. No, escort just sounds better than man-whore. Yep. I was damn good at my job, too. But after a while, I just felt like a piece of meat and had to quit.
You know what, man? Respect.
When I quit the escort job, I had enough money to buy a pistol belt and some other gear. Bodyguards make a good, honest living. And I had the wits and physical build to handle most thugs. After saving a few tourists from trouble, I got a reputation for being a stand-up guy again. And after a decade, managed to save up enough to retire.
Oh, well, good for you, man.
All right. Bye.
Submit to a credit check, or present your passport before proceeding to the gate. Trespassers will be shot.
So a science of 80 can get you through. I don't have 2,000 caps.
Admission to the strip requires an official passport or proof that you're carrying the required minimum balance. These policies prevent less reputable persons from entering and ensure a good time will be had by all who enter the strip. Please return. You have entered a restricted area. Exterminate.
Whoa. Do I have 2,000? No, I've only got 349. I could probably scrape up 2,000 pretty quickly, but right now I've only got 349.
Lasers, plasma, pistols, grenades. We've got it all at the Silver Rush.
Alright, well, there's a store.
afraid I'm going to have to search you before letting you in. The only weapons allowed on the premises are the ones we're selling. It should only take a moment. There. I've stored all of your weapons. You're clear to enter. When you leave, I'll hand them all back to you.
All right. Fair enough.
The bosses are having a meeting. You'll have to wait until it's over.
Mr. Soren, please get to the point. The second half of your payment is late, and I want to know why.
Miss Van Graaff, my associates and I have decided that we wish to renegotiate the terms of our deal.
Might I ask for what reason? The shipment was delivered. The guns were tested before leaving this facility.
Regardless, we feel that the quality of the weapons is below expectation and hope to adjust the price accordingly.
Well, that certainly is an approach.
Excuse me for a moment, would you? Do it. Never break faith with the Van Graaffs, Mr. Soren. I expect you'll have the rest of our payment ready tomorrow morning. Okay, everyone. Show's over. Back to work. Welcome to the Silver Rush, where only top-of-the-line energy weapons... Of course. Welcome to the Silver Rush. It just so happens a position opened up recently. We currently need another body to guard the entrance outside. Think you can handle that? Wonderful. I already have a man outside who can show you the ropes and get you set up. His name is Simon. He's been with the family for years, so listen to what he says and follow his instructions.
All right.
Hello.
Welcome to the Silv. Aw, crap. Don't tell me you're my new guard. Well, no time for pleasantries. I've got your gear right here, but let's see if you can follow instructions. You'll be covering the other side of the door there. Take your position while I get your stuff out. Good. Look around and get a feel for where customers and risks can enter and exit the area while I get your gear ready.
Can I have my other items back?
Okay, now let's get you... Standard issue is your run-of-the-mill combat armor, with a nice dark coat of paint for both brand recognition and sheer intimidation value. Next, your weapon. Guards are required to use rifles. Anything lighter compromises your combat effectiveness.
Anything heavier and people are too scared to come in the door. What's your preference, laser or plasma?
Nothing wrong with going plasma. Just make sure you hit what you're aiming at. Now that you're equipped, a quick word on the job at hand. In a nutshell, we're here to keep the riffraff away. Drunks, punks, and capless vermin are to be turned away. Potential customers are to be permitted normal entrance. That is, after we pat them down for weapons. An unarmed man is a lot less likely to try to steal something with several armed guards around.
don't start any fights. I don't care if some jet junkie just assaulted your mother. We're here to promote violence elsewhere, not started here. Lastly, don't abandon your post. We're getting paid to stand next to this door, not talk to someone down the street or head to the casino. That goes double for any thoughts of splitting with that gear. Every now and then, some young punk thinks he can run off with Van Graaff property. Trust me, the rifle and armor are nice, but they're not worth your life. Other than that, relax. Who knows? You might attract a high roller from the Wrangler over there and never have to pull a gig like this again. Settle in. You've got some hours left before your shift ends. Here comes a winner. I'll let you handle this one.
Hi there. Is this where I can pick up a laser gun? Sounds like a stupid policy to me.
Good. Stick to the rules. Another one coming. You're on.
Is there another one coming? Oh, yeah. Okay.
Hi. I was, in the area and thought I'd stop by to look at your weapons. Can I go in? Fine by me.
He's clean. See? Not so hard, is it? Heads up. Looks like we got another customer.
Well, this is an interesting side quest.
Howdy. I just done broke the bank over at the Wrangler there and thought I might peruse your fine wares. Maybe lighten my purse a little? Now hold on here. I'm not packing any heat. Ain't my word good enough for you?
No, it is not.
If that's the case, then I guess I'll go spend my money elsewhere.
Wow. You're a real people person, aren't you? Looks like that guy's headed this way. Don't screw it up.
You mean that guy way down there? It's a lot of, it's kind of standing around waiting for NPCs to walk cycle their way to you here.
Hey, looking for something to replace my old revolver. Mind if I head in? That's not really necessary, is it? I already told you I got this here revolver, right? Damn, I knew this wasn't gonna work.
Stop him! Now what in the hell do you suppose that was about? Help me clean this up. No one's gonna want to shop.
Oh, he's got C4.
Up here with the corpse out front. Crap. This I do not need today. Keep your head straight, rookie. Things are about to get interesting.
You might not want to stand there, Boo.
Looks like you've got a little helper today.
What can I say? Business has been good lately. We can afford to help.
Good to hear, buddy. So is the boss lady in?
You know she is. Why don't you go in and say hi?
Nah, I got some rounds to run. But do pass along that I'm always thinking of her. Actually, I got a better idea. Make the new hire tell her. You'll do that for me, won't you? That's a good dog. Well, I'm out of here. Later, Simon.
Way to keep
Does
your
it?
Head, rookie. Let's hope for you yet. It's just about closing time. Let's go see the boss about getting paid. Oh, I'm gonna need the rifle and armor back. Boss's orders.
Hey.
Simon's been telling me how it went. Let's do a quick recap. You had a little bit of a hard time following instructions, but didn't do too bad overall. Here's your pay. Unfortunately, I found someone else with a little more experience, and he'll take over the position starting tomorrow. However, another task has come up that I could use some help with, assuming you're still interested in making some money. There's a deal that we've been working on for a while now, and the buyer would like a sample of our weapons. I need you to run a package out to a discreet location that the client has chosen. Sound good? Good. Here's the package. I'll mark the location on your map. The buyer said they'd be in town for quite a while, so there's no rush. That said, try not to dawdle. This client could mean big money for us, which naturally means big money for you.
All right.
I was just telling Gloria about your performance. Hell of a first day, huh?
Okay, but how do I get my items back? Okay, I've got them. I just have to reassign everything. What is that gun? 5.56? Okay. Data quest. Birds of a feather. Boone's following me.
Wanna get lucky? Head on down to the Atomic Wrangler.
Hydrate. I can do that. Got some Beepus.
If it can be bought, it can be found at Mick and Ralph's. We've got stuff we're not even allowed to sell, people. Only at Mick and Ralph's.
Is that really something that you should be advertising, kid? You wanna fuck up again? Oh, I'm naked. Except for my hat, apparently. Hi, Heather Kelly. Thank you. Welcome to the stream. Day's going pretty good so far.
Morning.
Good morning, Rockface.
Spare a cap? I can make it worth your while.
Can you?
Oh, that's rich. You're not exactly my type. No offense. No, I meant I could give you a tip. Earn my money, so to speak. The first thing you should know is that Freeside is run by a pack of yahoos that call themselves the Kings. Their leader, who oddly enough calls himself the King, currently has his hands full trying to prevent an all-out riot in Freeside. That's two tips, but what the hell? You're a new customer, so the extra one's on me. Wanna hear another?
Yeah, maybe another time, bud. My hair is a fucking mess, and I really need to color it again, but that, to say it hasn't been in the cards. Alright, let's go rip somebody. I got lucky with just having really naturally curly hair that generally tends to look okay even when it's a mess. How far out here into the desert am I wandering? Not too terribly far. Let's hope we don't run into any rad scorpions or other various bullshit irradiated creatures. I should equip a gun. Maybe not that one. Oh, what the fuck was I just saying about rad scorpions? Yeah, I would especially not like to run into Cazadores. Those things are fucking scary.
Are you the Van Graaff's emissary? Do you have what we requested? I wasn't informed there was to be an exchange on my part. What are you talking about? That you would have something for me. Now, do you or not? Ah, then our business is concluded. Tell your superiors that we will contact them shortly.
Well, that was a fairly simple, straightforward delivery. A little suspiciously simple, but you know what? I'll take it. Kind of expecting to walk into an ambush there. Shame my speech isn't already at 75, or I probably could have extorted that guy a bit. I really just wanted to shoot my gun. Boone murdered that rat scorpion before I even had a chance to fire. Hell, he murdered that rat scorpion before I even saw it. Boone's really coming in clutch. Yeah, exactly. Sometimes you just gotta fire one off. Make sure people know not to fuck with you. Though the people here don't seem to be very good at knowing not to fuck with you. I mean, how many people have I rippered since... How many people have I had to chainsaw to get to death since arriving here? It's been a good few.
Welcome to the Silver Run.
Welcome back. Did you have news for me, or are you just here for the guns? And, don't leave me in suspense. What was their reaction? Good. Good. Here's your payment. If you'll excuse me, I have some thinking to do. Oh, Jean-Baptiste was talking about a matter earlier that he needs help with. I volunteered you. See him for the details.
Ah, just the person I was looking for. Your name came up in a discussion we had recently. My sister is very impressed with you so far, but I'm not. I don't think you have what it takes to work for this family. Luckily for you, I'm going to give you a chance to prove me wrong. What do you say? Want to make some real money? All right, then. If we're going to work together, there's only one thing you need to know about me. I like things simple. Recently, Glory negotiated a deal between us and a big-time player. We're talking more caps than you'd probably see in a lifetime. Your part in this is simple. To finalize this deal, I need to tie up a loose end. To do that, there's a girl I need you to find. Her name is Rose of Sharon Cassidy. That's some fancy shit, right? Don't know what her mother was thinking with a name like that. But this girl and I, we need to have a discussion. Find her. Bring her here so I can talk to her. One-on-one. Fuck no. If I knew where this bitch was, you think I'd be asking you? Still, there's someone who might. Old Alice McLafferty. Crimson Caravan might know something. She keeps tabs on caravan traffic in the Mojave. Wouldn't put it past her to keep track of Cassidy Caravans and its owner.
All right.
Find her, bring her back here so we can talk. Needless to say, there's some good money in it for you.
need to sort my weapons out again. Crimson Caravan, come.
Wanna get lucky? Head on down to the Atomic Wrangler.
I'm good, thank you. If you know, people bought, to stab, bodies to eat. Nick and Ralph's.
If it can be bought, it can be found at Nick and Ralph's.
You just said that, kid.
Need some grub? I got you covered. Cheap and filling. Typically, I find it goes down better if I leave people guessing. So what do you say? Want some? I have my little helpers out and about, always looking for fresh things to add to the stew pot. You may have seen them around somewhere yourself. Now deny your hunger no longer. You'll be back.
This gentleman and I were just settling on a price. I'm afraid you'll have to hire one of the others this time around.
This man's prices are steep, but I hear he's worth it.
Well, I mean, if you're gonna get a bodyguard, get one with a good reputation.
Welcome to the Crimson Caravan Company, New Vegas branch. What may I do for you? Coincidentally, I'm also looking for her. I've got a business offer she'd be interested in. I believe Cass frequents the Mojave Outpost, far south of here, near the California border. It's been a pleasure.
I'm not walking all the way over there.
Looking for trouble? Well, keep those eyes up and turning, or I'll set them spinning. Got no time for gawkers, or anyone looking for something I ain't selling. How about a drink? How about a couple, is what you mean. Drinking to forget, and it's only getting
about a drink?
Mad instead. Whiskey always gets my temper up, now
have a drink.
Ever. Drinking used to cause all sorts of trouble back west. Before I punched enough people, that is. And they learned to lay low when the whiskey hit.
include...
Lost my caravan heading north. The driver burned to ash. And they didn't even take the cargo. They just burned that too. My guess is Legion. They're trying to cut NCR's supply line. And the Mojave outpost is proof. Got us locked up tighter than a New Vegas virgin. No caravans in, out, and just try arguing with Jackson about it. Roads aren't safe, he says. No shit, you washed out old fuck-up. I didn't need a Brotherhood scribe to tell me that. Yeah, he's been with NCR so long, all he can see is the worst outcome of everything. So he doesn't do anything. Jackson won't let me head north. It's not safe.
I'm a big fan
Even
of Fireball.
Even though my caravan's gone, my caravan papers are keeping me here. So if you came here for work...
It's very taste.
My advice? Go find the Crimson Caravan branch south of Vegas. They can help you out. No shit. Drinks on me, then. Still, not like I'm going anywhere. Caravan title's still keeping me here, even though it's dead and gone. What's on your mind? Jean-Baptiste. Sounds like someone got knocked out of the good book so hard his name broke. Either that, or it's Canadarian or some such shit. So who is this Baptiste, and what does he want? The only Van Graffs I know are the ones out west. Well, except for Gloria Van Graff, and I don't know her all that well. Nor do I want to. Don't have any objection speaking with him. Though if he's with the Van Graffs, he should know I'm not looking to buy weapons. Whiskey and me are old friends. Keeps me going when times get rough. Like now. Got me into the caravan business, you know. Had to start transporting water instead of liquor, though. If I hadn't switched over, I'd end my trip with nothing but glass bottles rattling on the back of the Brahmin.
Damn. Okay, I saw a quest thing pop up. Cass is drowning her sorrows at the Mojave Outpost. Her advice, go work for the Crimson Caravan. Okay, but how do I get her to follow me?
You come around like a bad... Not leaving here until my caravan papers clear. Or my title goes away. If you were looking for someone to caravan with, I'd try the Crimson Caravan up north. They pretty much run the roads now.
We won't go quietly. The Legion can count on...
What am I doing on caps? 700... So not great. Not doing great on caps. Guess I'll go see what the Crimson Caravan needs for now.
Nah.
Well, unless she has something else for me to do.
You come around like a bad habit. What's on your mind? If you're looking to sign on with a caravan? No. Traders are bottled up tight here. Caravan works up north. Check with a Crimson Caravan, maybe. Gunrunners might have work. Wouldn't know for sure, though. Still, if you got a gun, guts, and feeling like going on patrol, might be some of... I don't know. Seems to be a lot of attention on Nipton. Word is, one of the snipers in the nest on the roof spotted smoke from the east. Yeah, her name's Ghost or something. Fucking scary. Ooh. Guess it's because you'll never see her till you're dead. NCR and their goddamn nicknames. As if Caesar himself's gonna piss and run if he hears them. Anyway, go on and head up top. Ask her what's going on if you haven't already. I don't much give a shit. Jackson might have something for you if you haven't already spoken to that old buzzard. He was looking to try to get troops to clear the North Road. You can find him over in the other building.
All right.
Evening.
Up on the roof.
You a courier? If so, this might be your lucky day. If you don't mind walking a bit, and your eyes are good. I think there's trouble in Nipton. No traffic from there on the roads. While I can explain that away, the smoke from the town I can't. I'm sure it's been hit. What I need to know is if they survived it. Might be powder gangers with all that smoke in the air. If there's anybody left, they'd be in the Nipton Town Hall. Go there. Check it out. Legion this far west? You're fucking kidding me. That's not outside the border. They're moving in, and fast. Nipton wasn't the most friendly town, but... All right. Thanks for checking on that. Wish it set my mind at ease. Now I'm more on... Unless you burn the town, don't take blame that's not due. Things are gonna get uglier before the year's out. Well, thanks for hoofing it there and back, even if it was bad news. Wish we could spare the troops to go hunting, but... Orders are to stay put. Fucking Mojave's going to hell. And all I can do is sit here and watch. Thanks for the assist. Wish others around here had your drive.
You've done a good turn for the NCR, and now we'd like to do one for you. Here's an NCR emergency two-way radio. You call, and we'll come running. You're not alone out here. The NCR has your back. Stay safe and good hunting.
Oh. That's neat.
You come around like a bad hat. You're looking at it. It's a watering hole without much to brag about. It's like a Brahmin drive gone wrong. Supposed to be a gate north, but you come here, you get caught in the pen. Better to head back home. If you don't have a gun and a will, don't matter much what you do when you reach here, except stare at that fucking monument outside. Don't even tell me you missed it coming in. It's like NCR showing its dick to all the east. If the Republic put as much effort into protecting the East as they put into those two asinine giants outside, then they'd be worth that monument. Statues of two men shaking hands covered in blood don't seem to be nothing to brag about. I'm speaking figurative. Isn't any blood on their damn hands. Of course, when Caesar comes walking through here, there'll be blood for
hey,
real.
Hey, Cora, thanks for the resub.
And after the blood dries in the sun, he'll melt that piece of jet-induced sculpture down and reshape it into a bull, which by my reckoning is making up for a deficiency of his. But no matter what the state of his pecker, he's sure giving the West a good fucking. One's a ranger, one's an NCR trooper, supposed to represent
pretty good
unification
so far, having
of
a
West
good time.
And East, or some such shit. As far as those two iron lovebirds go, they've got more spine you'll see in a year from the NCR government. Huh. Maybe you're right. Brim tats always throw me off. Well, fine, whatever. They can be shaking each other's dicks. Wouldn't change the Mojave now. What's on your...
Alright, well, there's nothing else that I can ask her, so... I guess we go work for the caravan company.
Hey.
Oh, she's gonna be asleep, huh? Okay.
Morning.
Welcome back. Certainly. What would you like to know? Well, the Gunrunners continue to dominate the weapons market, and the Mormon traders from New Canaan control the majority of the northern routes. All right. I'm afraid we have no current openings for caravanners or guards, but I am in need of a runner. Deliver this invoice to Dr. Hildern. You can find him somewhere inside Camp McCarran. It's been a pleasure.
All right. Just pop over to Camp McCarran real quick. Just a sec. Maybe not up top?
A pleasure to meet you. I'm Dr. Thomas Hildern, Director of Operations, OSI East. I presume you're here about Vault 22? Wonderful. Straight to it, then. Have you signed the release forms? No? Doesn't matter. We'll keep that to ourselves.
Vault 22, you
said. Vault 22. Where to begin? Imagine, if you will, the wasteland in bloom. Vast fields of corn that grow from seeds and produce their bounty in the space of a month. Orchards of trees, their branches weighed halfway to the ground, hung with fat, ripe oranges, a harvest that could feed a city or a nation. And all this, requiring no more than a few drops of precious water and the efforts of only a handful of human farmers. Impossible? Precisely. Science has proven that truth 1,000 times over. But how many wasteland savages believe it? present company excepted, of course. The bounty I describe to you is no idle fantasy. It exists in primitive form only a few miles from where we stand. We need only reach out and unlock its secret. For that, the OSI needs you. Good. I thought I sensed the kindred soul in you, beneath the wasteland veneer. I believe that the inhabitants of Vault 22 unlock the secrets of vegetative growth.
Is that right?
Plants are spilling from their gate. No one tends them. No one waters them. Yet they multiply and spread in all directions. Find the reason for this miraculous growth, and I promise you the OSI will see that you are generously compensated.
Well, that does sound like fun.
Good. No need to check in with the NCR authorities. I can authorize your payment from OSI accounts. Vaults typically contain a server room on a lower level, where they would have backed up their research data. A computer room, you understand? Download all the information on the central server to your Pip-Boy, and you'll be certain to bring me any notes or samples that you find, won't you? Oh? What might those be?
Okay, so I am supposed to be bringing
yes?
you something.
Something else you needed?
There we go.
From Alice. I'll see that she's paid right. Crimson Caravan runs a tight operation. Even out here in the waste, wouldn't do to keep them waiting. Was there anything else? Or were you just here about the invoice? Yes. Goodbye.
Okay, now what's this about Vault 22? Here.
Did Dr. Hildern... This really isn't any of my business, but... Did he give you a job? Not interested. More concerned. It's just... You're not the first person he sent to Vault 22. And I know he'd never tell you. There were a lot of mercs. One after another. None of them came back. Then, about a week ago, there was a scientist, Keeley. She's unusual. Not the sort of person you'd expect, but she's an absolute genius, and he didn't mention her? Not even her name? Or any of the other mercs? But now he's hired you, which means one of two things. Either he heard back from Keeley, and she failed, or he's given up on her. Listen, I make a fair wage, but I'm not rich. Not by any means. Maybe my kind of money wouldn't appeal to your average merc. But I'm willing to pay you if you'll find Keeley and make sure she's safe. Isn't right leaving her out there. No idea if she's alive or dead. I had a good feeling about you. Moment you walked in. I mean it. Right.
All right. See about finding her too. Yeah, we'll rock with the plasma pistol for now. Oh no, I'm not super great on energy weapons. We'll just go with that gun. Alright, let's go explore a vault. Ready to go explore a vault, Boone?
What is it? Okay. No, it doesn't. Okay. Yeah.
All right, let's head to Vault 22 and hope we don't get our shit turned inside out on the way over there. Guessing it's up in the hills. Let's see if we can get... Oh god. Azadors.
Alright. It's over.
Oh, I really don't want to fuck with them. Oh, it's over there. Okay. with me, Boone? No? Oh, there he is. Oh, God! Lance kill.
All clear. All clear.
I've established a temporary camp inside the entrance of the vault. Power inside is minimal but still running, and I've managed to hack into one of their security terminals. The logs show that several people have entered the vault over the past few months, but none have left. It's getting late, so I'll resume the expedition in the morning. The growth in the interior matches the exterior to a T. It's a little surprising given the scarcity of sunlight in the entrance. But even more surprising in that they seem to originate from further below. Maybe the fool Hildren was onto something after all. Since my Pip-Boy is on the fritz, I'll try to keep a running log of my discoveries in whatever computers I can find and collate the data before. Maintenance, look into that ductwork here on level 2 again. I know you guys took a look, but I swear that I'm back. I even have other people that can back me up. Well, they definitely managed to grow plants. Level seems to have been devoted to the study of atmospheric effects on plants. Concentration on producing plants with a high oxygen. Given the problems these variants have, it sounds like a reasonable avenue of concern. Strange, but some sections of the machinery down here appear to have been modified for some unknown purpose. Restraints regarding oxygen content and pressure have been bypassed. I've been hearing a motherfucker. I mean, that's a good reason as any to not want to leave. I've been hearing a strange chittering sound for some time now, and finally discovered its source. There's some kind of giant mantises that have taken up residence in the vault. I almost ran smack into one the other day, but the creatures don't appear to react to my presence at all. Perhaps the others sent here ran afoul of the creatures. But I can't see how a few scattered insects could pose so much of a problem to me. I just saw one. Can't slip through there. There's no door. Food production area. Or a carrier. Assistant Mathers went into the caves at each today and still hasn't returned, requesting escort for science purposes. We need a medical team up here now. Dr. Pete returned with one of the security guards who is horribly wounded. Asked them what the security officer or where they were, they just failed and shook his head. In the meantime, Dr. Bailey has ordered that the door to the caves be sealed until a further investigation. To hold off, please send security at once. Okay. Requires key. Yields continue to improve, splicing together RGN-188 with the existing corn samples, produced a hybrid that responds better to the artificial lights we have. Side note, Dr. Pete missed his third straight day due to illness. His ethic hasn't exactly been stellar to this point, so I'm requesting confirmation from the clinic that he is in fact sick. On a lark, the guys came down in pest control, sent up a sample of a substance. one of their specimens secretes to attract insects. Tests show that the substance has a mood-altering effect on smaller mammals. If anyone volunteers, we can begin human testing soon. So they started getting sick because of human testing. Not much to report today. The mood is unusually somber in the wake of Dr. Peter's passing. There's a strange rumor going around that the commotion downstairs was caused by, of all things, Dr. Peter's corpse suddenly animating and attacking me. I don't know who would start such a rumor, but it's an exceptionally bad taste. Oh, Jesus.
Keep looking. Keep looking.
Ah, more expedition entry. Finally found some of the bodies that of the scientists that lived here. They appear to be overgrown with some form of lichen. They blend in so well with the other growth that I walked right by several of them without even noticing them. Taking the proper precautions, but lichen doesn't seem to be contagious, at least to ghouls. This level appears to be where they performed most of the research in PR's entry. I've been able to collect a little, but the vast majority of the data from the done here is inaccessible. I'll have to find the main backup and download. Yeah, these things are plant-based. Yeah, I felt like that might would be effective. Okay. That door goes down to the lower level. A bar here. Oh hey, a carrot. Oh hey, a carrot. Oh hey, an apple. Guess no one will miss this ridiculous trivia game. The questions weren't even that hard. It looks like this is where most of the people were when they died. Medical reports I found suggest that most of them succumbed to some kind of airborne infection. I'm going to see if I can convert some of the grow lamps into UV spectrometers. Test the airflow for contaminant. After numerous attempts, I found a range that highlights particles in the air that I believe killed everyone in this vault. Preliminary tests show them to be spores of something. Set up spectrometers on several of the levels now. Concentration appears to increase in the lower level. At this point, I'm concerned the plants here may constitute a danger to CR. I really need to play the newer Doom games. Utility. There were minor discrepancies in the mass of the air being pumped through the vault, but no harmful gases were detected. Also, strange residue has been affected. Air filters, inverted bright. Ooh, flamer fuel. The damn notifications are still trying to catch up from me destroying them with this fucking thing. Gonna pump them. Well, not quite all of them. We'll put one in a. Well, we'll put one more in speech. So we'll bring science to 50. Bring that to 55. Oh, we get a new perk. Swift Learner. Comprehension. Double the bonus from reading magazines and one additional point from skill books. And will often explode. And you'll do 5% extra damage. A belly toughness. Boss. Green Imperial of Bone Wall. Oh, we have a lot of perks to choose from. I think I'm gonna take Swift Learner this time.
I've got nothing.
Ah, cave door key card. That was like a fucked up Venus flytrap. Okay. Dr. Peters is suffering from a severe case of pneumonia, the result of the spread of some sort of microorganism in his lungs. The entire group showed up throughout the course of the day, displaying the same symptoms, remarkably similar to Dr. Peters' condition. Dr. Peters isn't responding to treatment, or more accurately, his body is actively rejecting the treatment. Okay. Oh, shit. Over encumbered. By 1 pound. Okay. Well, I've got 2 357s, so I don't really need both. Oh, let's keep the good. I guess we're going to the caves now. No, these stairs are blocked, so... The entrance to the caves was on this level. Need to heal. This is back up in the oxygen cycling. might need. Since there's like a ton of spores or whatever, having filters might be a good idea. I don't know if I'm gonna end up needing them or not, but they didn't have any weight, so. Yeah, it was. Yeah, I couldn't get in there earlier, that's why I went ahead up to that level. Just a sec, I have to attend to it. You know what? I think now is a good time for some whiskey. Cheers. A distant relative of the more commonly known Venus flytrap. Seems to be performing well. Plants are a threat to creatures up to 5 times their size due to the violent nature of their closing maws. Those that are swallowed whole are often incapacitated by their initial bite. Plant's lack of mobility is offset by their ability to lure prey into reach by means of a nectar they secrete from their... Of all the species we brought with us, the most common, or the common mantis, exceeds the rest in terms of predation. The insects are voracious, and their camouflage allows them to attack prey by surprise. Also, they complement our botanical specimens by hunting down those pests that avoid our escape. Our other measures. Lastly, mantises will begin to cannibalize one another when other food is scarce, making their numbers self-regulating when prey is scarce. Entomopathogenic fungus developed to colonize the bodies of most common pests. Once it is fully colonized a host body, the host technically dies, but the body continues to move by means of the fungal colony within. So basically, they created the fungus that's fucking them. But plant, yeah. Boone got knocked the fuck out. Come on, Boone. Wake up. I wish my mouse button stopped bugging out on me. Boone, I don't remember granting you leave.
Took your sweet time. I suppose the NCR sent you. Oh, she's such a dear. Not like that pompous little pedant she works for. But that's neither here nor there. These plants have gotten completely out of control. I've got a plan to deal with them, but I'll need your help. Good. Meet me on the second level, and I'll explain what needs to be done.
Hey, Boone's back. Welcome back, buddy. I'm gonna have to dock your pay since you went absent without leave there for a minute, but, you know. Well, if anything's gonna wake you up, it might as well be gunfire.
This Vault-Tec machinery is so fragile. I had to jury-rig this elevator a few days, and it's on the fritz again already. Ah, that's got it. See you upstairs.
Ah, I'm glad I decided to look for you.
You're here. Ready to begin? Time is of the essence, so I'll be brief. This place is filled with spores that are toxic to humans, and we need to get rid of them. I've pumped the vault full of a highly flammable gas that, once ignited, should destroy the vast majority of spores. There's one problem, though. The gas becomes semi-inert on exposure to oxygen, meaning the gas will have to be ignited close to where it's being introduced. I need you to find the vents where the gas is being pumped and ignite it. Oh. And survive the resulting blast. In the area where the gas is active, any kind of fire or explosion should do the trick. Hell, even lasers would do the job. If you don't have anything like that, I've got some grenades in my bag in the corner that you can use. I set the gas to pump into the fifth level since that's where the concentration of spores was highest. I'd start looking there. Typically, these vaults use circular vents in their air circulation systems. Look for a wall with two of them almost side by side. There's one just around the corner outside this lab if you need an example. Yes, there'll be an explosion when the gas is ignited, but I'm sure you'll... Good.
Lasers, huh? I think I can work with that. So I'm looking for something like this on the fifth level. Yeah. Okay, how am I gonna do this in a way that I can survive? The C4 remote?
I'll watch my step.
Oh, it acts as a mine. Okay, how am I supposed to do this thing? I think this is as far away as I can be and still hit it.
Grenade!
Nope, that didn't work. Well, I just tried to hide in a room, but it didn't really work out. Well, yes, that's what I was trying to do. I'm not fast enough to run back to the elevator. The elevator is right here. But I'll show you if I have to come through here.
Grenade!
Chuck the grenade. And caught. Maybe. Get in here, Boone. Ah. I think it is. I'll look around a little bit more, but I think that's the only one. Goes to the common areas. Is the data room reinforced?
Grenade!
Oh, it is! Good call, Ben. Whatever, I'll take it.
Ah, good. You survived. I was beginning to think you hadn't. You'll be pleased to know that the spore should no longer be a problem. Now all that's left is to ensure that none of this ever happens again. The research that led to these abominations must be erased. I've managed to create a connection to the vault's backup system from here. I just have to remotely delete all the files, and we're done here. Indeed. This should only take a minute. Just a few more moments and... That's strange. The system says that the files were accessed recently and copied to an external source. You wouldn't happen to know anything about that, would you?
I could lie. I'll be honest.
Yes, that sounds like something he'd do. Well, there's nothing for it, then. Those files need to be erased. Hold out your arm and I'll have it done in a flash. Glad you're thinking clearly. I was afraid to blink there for a second. There, all done. That wasn't so bad, was it? I've unlocked the door, so you're free to run along now. Although it pains me to say it, I wouldn't have made it out of here without your help. If you're heading back toward McCarran, tell Dr. Williams that she has my thanks as well.
Okay, here's the thing. Jamgram might be bad person, but she's not bad person. That's fair, but let's be honest. Like, let's look at who we'd be giving it to. We'd be giving it to someone who's going to use it to essentially do the same fucking thing again. And if he does, the entire Mojave is gonna turn into a spore monster-ridden forest? I mean, it wouldn't necessarily be bad to have a forest, but... The spores would spread, and it would essentially be a second calamity. That's my thinking, at least, is that by destroying that research, which, generally speaking, yes, destroying research is a bad thing, but by making it so that research can't be accessed, we're preventing another calamity from happening. They're not even people. They're just fungus.
I heard the director. But Wait a... Now look here.
She wouldn't let him finish a sentence. Just reamed him out for sending all those people to the vault. I've never seen his face so red and twitchy. Thanks for keeping her safe. Here's the caps I promised. I knew I had a good feeling about... Thanks again.
Oh, damn. 800 caps for that? Fuck. Worth it. Oh, nice. We leveled up. Bring that up to 60. We'll bring energy weapons up to 30.
Welcome back.
Thanks.
Well, you've proven yourself reliable so far. Would you be interested? As much as I like to handle matters personally, I can't be everywhere at once. There is a negotiation with a smaller trading outfit that I'd like resolved as quickly as possible. There's also the matter of Henry Jameson, an employee whose services I'd rather do without. His family connections make it difficult, however. And finally, I need someone to acquire the Gunrunner's manufacturing specifications. This job needs to be quiet. No alarms, no deaths. There's a small trading outfit, Cassidy Caravans, that I'm interested in acquiring. They've been rather competitive, so it's time to buy them out. I have it on good authority that the owner, Cass, wants out of the caravan business. Cass frequently trades with the NCR, so you'll likely find her at the Mojave Outpost.
Nice.
Fancy meeting you here, friend.
Oh, this fucking guy.
Yep. This is getting mighty embarrassing. People gonna start to talk. Now, it ain't my fault that Dorothy and the Tin Man happen to be on the same yellow-striped road, is it? Just rolling along on my spurs. Looks like I just might make it to New Vegas after all. Yep. Guess it's just down to you and Fancy Pants. I wouldn't worry about him. He looks all hat and no cattle, if you ask me. Fancy Pants? No, I ain't seen hiding a hair of him since the tussle in Good Springs. I'm sure he ran back. Look me up when you get to New Vegas. I'll buy the first round.
All right, Victor. How many caps do I have now? 1,713.
You come around like a bad habit. What's on your mind? They want to buy Cassidy Caravans? Don't they know it's burned to ash? No. Even times being what they are, not sure I'm looking to sell. Even for all the whiskey in Reno. If someone came up to you and offered you 1,000 caps for your name, would you take it? Actually, you know what? Fuck it. I don't want any. Point is, I made the caravan what it is. It's mine. Alice McLafferty, eh? No, I see the zeros, and I know she's good for them. Still, it's not about the money. Dad'd spin like a twister if he ever heard I sold our name for anything. Look, I know you came all this way, and that takes some drive, especially these days. Just doesn't feel right, trading history for a slip of paper. That's a good point. It's the caravan clearance that's got me stuck here. I'm sure this bar's getting tired of propping me up. Give me that paper. I'll put my name to it. No sense trying to hold the pass between your fingers when it's nothing but dirt. All right. There you go. Caravan's yours. Feel kind of relieved, actually. Guess I didn't realize how much I was carrying around with just the name. No idea. Maybe head back west? Though the idea of heading back there with my tail between my legs isn't appealing. You got one too many by my count.
What is it? If that's what you think. All right. Guess I'll be around Novak for a while longer until I figure out what I want to do with myself.
That's what I've been working toward this
whole
time.
See you around.
Oh, that's what the red thing was. It was Boone's spotter perk.
You come around like a bad habit. Don't know. Go with you? And why the hell would I do that? So you're looking for someone to help, not just tag along. Huh. Walking the Mojave with you can't be any worse than here, that's for sure. Back here again?
I don't know. I'll check in a sec. While Cass is a companion, she and the player gain damage threshold when they drink whiskey. Additionally, the player does not suffer intelligence loss from consuming alcohol and ignores the negative effects of alcohol addiction. So basically, drink booze and I take less damage and don't get any of the negative side effect. Which is kinda great.
McLafferty's been riding asses again.
Welcome back. Very good. On occasion, it's proven to be more profitable in the long run to simply buy out the competition. And this is one of those occasions. The Jamesons are very wealthy ranchers back in Redding, California, and significant investors in the Crimson Caravan Company. I was pressured into posting young Henry as the manager of the New Vegas branch. As you can see, he wasn't exactly cut out for the job. He was much more interested in gambling and prostitutes, and because of his family, I can't simply fire him. Henry needs to be convinced to quit, one way or another. The quality of the Gunrunner's armaments is due to their manufacturing process. They craft all weapons on site. I want to know the secrets of their manufacturing process, which means you'll need to find some way to get inside their heavily guarded factory. I would greatly prefer that you perform this job undetected and with... I understand. No hard feelings.
Yeah, I don't have enough sneak to be doing that. And, like, I guess I could theoretically use, I guess I could theoretically use Stealth Boys, but then I'd have to... actually have, like... I could theoretically use Stealth Boys to do it, but then I'd have to find Stealth Boys.
But she knows what she's doing, that's for sure.
And I feel like at that point there are probably more uses for Stealth Boys, that like there's more things that I could use this for that I would rather use them for than just like stealing trade secrets for some random caravan runner.
You want someone 40? Dead, the atomic really dead, stop by the Silver Rush.
Hello.
As I live and breathe, Rose of Sharon Cassidy, the late Rose of Sharon Cassidy, was hoping you were on that caravan I massacred, but... Crimson Caravan and Van Graffs won't need to worry about you anymore. Wahhabi's ours, and we're shutting you down for good. Really? We'll see about that.
Over here.
Jesus. They just wanted to fucking kill her? Is there a way that I can, like, talk him out of this?
As I live and breathe.
No, there is not.
Over here.
And I can't equip my fucking saw. Alright, well, we're not doing that quest. How am I doing on funding? Hey, we got enough. Yeah, exactly. Screw that shit. Fucking thugs.
Submit to a credit check or present your pass. Thank you, madam.
Howdy, partner. You've come for a piece, haven't you? Welcome to New Vegas. Sorry, Rambler. I know you're fixing to serve up some vengeance, but I'm gonna have to point you to the Lucky 38 first. Mr. House, the head honcho of New Vegas, is itching to make your acquaintance. Don't you dawdle, little doggy. Mr. House.
That's it. Keep moving.
I can barely see the street.
It's hard to sleep in this place, I tell you. Last night, some girl was coming.
What? And I still have to pick. I mean, I'm going to. I was just going to go to the tops first.
Hey, hey, baby doll. Welcome to the Tops Hotel and Casino. I'm going to have to add... Smooth. Oh, and a friendly word of advice. If you happen to stumble across any weapons during your stay here, well, now that we got that little business out of the way, what can I do to make... Relax, baby. The safe is houses. We'll keep them locked up in the bank upstairs right next to the money. Have a good...
Hello?
What in the goddamn... Let's keep this in the groove, hey? Smooth moves, smooth. Hello. It was you wiped out the cons down in Boulder City? You did that? Oh, shit.
I hit what I was aiming for. Guess you had brains to spare. Or you just thick-skulled. Either way, baby, this is good news. Maybe I can finally sleep at night, knowing you didn't die. What say you and me cash out? Go somewhere that's more private-like. Any questions you got, I'll answer. You want a reason? How about four? They're called bodyguards, and every one of them is packing. Me too, so baby makes five. Add to that, every chairman in this joint is armed, and not with some holdout pea shooter like maybe you smuggled through security. Anyhow, baby... You didn't come here for vengeance. You came to get clued in. Like I said, we should be talking. To start, I'll comp you the presidential. Best suite in the house. You deserve a taste of the VIP lifestyle. I'll hang out down here for a while to make everything look business as usual, then come to you. Any questions you got, I'll answer. Guaranteed. Why would I do that, baby? I want to talk to you as much as you want. And you dig, this is just first base, right? You and me have a future together, and it's big league and open all. Here's the key to the prez. I'll see you there in two shakes.
Keep those hands where I can see them.
Alright, I think this is about as good a place as any to stop for today. Um, So now that I have the office, I'm going to be streaming a lot more often. I'll be back on... The next stream will be on Wednesday, around the same time, 1 p.m. Central. Let's see, is there anything else I need to go over? Probably going to be doing Fallout again. There are some other things that I want to stream that are just kind of little one-off. Just play it for a bit and then, you know, move on type things. I'm going to throw it over to the patron card and the credits. So thanks for watching and I'll catch y'all next time.